finally back with more shit, which is what I should have called the series. Just shit. Because I have a lot of shit. And where should I even begin? I guess we'll start with this fucking box that I've had sitting around for like a month. And I feel like I'm gonna have like another one coming in like a week. So I'm gonna feel stupid doing this all over again. But whatever. Let's get it out of the way. I don't know what the theme is. But it looks like a companion cube? Fuck. Okay, so we have... Oh! A cool shirt for an actual good game! That's actually... No, what the hell is this? What the fuck? Come on, you fucking box! Unfold and flatten, flip and refold, ta-da, your own companion cube. Oh. Well, there we go, now I have a project. Oh, what is this shit? It's a Proto Man box. I bet he's gonna look fucking stupid, like Derpy Mega Man down there. Wow, I didn't realize I moved him. And does he look like shit? It's just a helmet. So it's just Proto Man's helmet. Because, you know, why give me all of Proto Man when I can have just a fucking helmet? Psychonauts. Well, that's a good game, but what the fuck is it? Oh, these goggles? Yeah, they're fucking goggles. And I bet you... There's no fucking way this is gonna fit me. No, see, like... No. This is just gonna tighten it, so this should... theoretically loosen. Who the fuck has a head this small? Well, it was cool for a second, but now it's ass. Okay, it's more portal looking thing. What is it? Is it a tie? It is a tie. Holy shit. I haven't worn a tie in like... fuck knows how long. Let's see if I still remember how to tie a tie. Do I want it to be a long tie? Holy shit, this is a long fucking tie. What? Anyway. Let me see if I remember how to tie a tie. This is how you do it. I think I just fucked it up. No. Ah, I did just fuck it up. Oh. No, wait. It's salvageable. There you go. Shut up! I'm trying to film something. Really? Okay. So now that that stopped, let's try to make this fucking companion cube. Which means, I guess I'm just gonna throw all this shit. There we go. Oh wait, there's a pen. What was the thing? Mad science. Yeah, no, that makes sense. What's this? It's a poster. So, fuck. How was I supposed to do this? Huh? unfold them flat and flip it. Okay. So, how can I unfold this without ruining the box? Huh. I guess we're gonna find out. This is gonna suck. I'm already not happy. God, fuck. Motherfucker. It's like, unfold it. Yeah, okay, I got that. But it's done in a way where the fucking tabs are impossible to get. You know, I don't plan this shit. It just so happens that every fucking box I get my hands on pisses me off. Just... Come on, you motherfucker. Oh my god. I kinda got it. But at this point, it's gonna be the most crushed fucking companion key. Oh. Oh. Oh, thank you, Christ. I should make this... Should make it a little easier. But so... Motherfuck! There we go. Give me a fucking companion cube. I gotta build it my own. Okay. Fuck, now I really don't know what I'm doing. Alright, so I'm assuming this tab goes here, this tab goes here. This flips around. I guess this. Fuck me. Gonna go like this. I don't know, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense, I'm gonna be honest. I'm a little... Oh. I didn't want it to fucking stay in place, but it doesn't. There you go. And that was the Mad Science Loot Crate, or Loot Gaming, whatever the fuck it is. So let's just start with something else. Well, I guess we'll start with something simple, like an IBM PC Junior joystick for the IBM PC Junior I don't own. Definitely a good purchase. You can't live without this. Oh my god, this is awful. This is the joystick? Well, I mean, it doesn't feel too ass, but it looks very ass. So that's that. I'm just gonna toss it to the side. Because who cares? I also got this Frogger arcade machine, and, well, it's a mini arcade machine, but what I didn't know ever in my life was the point of Frogger is apparently to get to work. That never occurred to me at all, yet he's wearing a tie and he has a briefcase, so I'm assuming he's got some kind of important office job, because he also has a watch on, so that means he's running late. And that's why he's dodging traffic? But I swear to God, I just thought it was about a frog crossing the road. With no motivation whatsoever. So, this is cool. Go right here. Oh my God, there's so much shit. I think I will go with a factory sealed Socrates game around the world. And there's nothing quite like an educational console. Educational game that misspells awareness while also spelling it correctly? back. Because even on the back, it says awareness. And it's spelled properly. But on the very front, it says awareness. So that's always a good sign. If you want to educate your children, make sure they don't know how to spell while they go on an adventure in world geography. That's some shit right there. Bam! That's one. Speaking of bam, kaboom! Yeah, I said I didn't want any of these fucking Atari games in boxes, but this I got with some other shit. And this is a good game, so fuck it. It's here, it exists, now I have it, it takes up space. What the hell is this? Astro Smash for the Intellivision. Another console I don't even own. So I can't wait to not play it and instead have it sit on the shelf. Because that's good. Oh fuck. I don't know the name of this game. I wrote it down somewhere, I swear to God. Let me take a look. I know. Okay. Yeah, I had to write it down somewhere. Momotaru Dentetsu DX. Oh, excuse me. Super Momotaru Dentetsu DX. What is it about? I don't know, because there's a lot of text boxes, but it's like a board game. So it's shit, because I can't fucking read any of it. So that's that game. I guess I'll just grab... Speaking of weird Japanese shit, Puzzle Star Suite for the PlayStation. Which is a very good puzzle game. But it's really weird. There's like these weird characters. I think the goal is to like... get with some dude? It's a puzzle game, but that's the goal, so that's cool. And I also got Shenmue. I don't really need to explain Shenmue too much, because everyone knows Shenmue. But I don't know why I didn't fucking own it already. Oh god, it's too much fucking shit. Shenmue's awesome, nice Dreamcast game. Carrier, which is actually great. It's like a nice campy Resident Evil game. This might even be in another episode, but I don't remember, and I don't want to go back and watch it, because I'm exceptionally lazy today. So, that's that. Wandering Hands. Got some Saturn games. Scud the Disposable Assassin, which is a... kind of reminds me of, a Doug Tenapel game, kind of like Earthworm Jim. It's actually really good, but... with the Saturn controller that I have, it's awful because the D-pad is shit. It's like the original controller. And you really want that second version of the controller for this. Are you ready for Scud? Yeah. Well, basically you're a robot that you can buy in a vending machine for like a quarter to kill someone. But once they kill that person, they have to kill themselves, you know, self-destruct. But he realizes he doesn't want to die, so instead of killing that person, he puts that person in a coma and then kills other people to make money to pay for his medical bills, to keep him alive as long as possible. So that's a fun game. I like this game. And the other one I got for Saturn, Virtual Hydlide, which most people hate, and part of me fucking hates it too, but I love these digitized actor games, and this one, it's kind of like Dark Souls if the entire game was in Blighttown. And for those who don't play Dark Souls, it's like playing a game that runs at like 8 frames per second all the way through. It's fun to play for me, but at the same time, it's really nauseating because the whole game is just chugging along. Barely functioning. I don't know how the fuck they even released this. That's an Atlas game. Usually when I see Atlas, I think it's gonna be fucking amazing. But it's still fun. Granted, you know, just gonna get sick every time you play it. I guess now, let me grab we have this pile of Genesis games. What is this one? The Revenge of Shinobi, which I love Shinobi. They're just all fucking ninja games. They're so awesome. I think that might be an 80s thing. Like everything was ninjas. And then you had robots and you had like knights and shit like that. But I fucking love Shinobi, so that's great. Cool Spot, which is a game about the 7-Up mascot, Spot. And I actually played this when I was a kid and I loved it. And it still holds up. It's almost like a bullet hell game. Which is surprising because it's just a game about soda. Soda mascot. What's this one? Sonic Spinball. It's Sonic and it's pinball. That's it. There's nothing else you need to say. It's fun. It does what it says on the cover. This one is Tiny Toon Adventures Buster's Hidden Treasure. Which is just another Tiny Toon game. They're good games. They're like Mario 3 clones of his. And Toy Story. Which I actually had as a kid and I fucking love this game. Even if, you know, it's a little old. But it holds up rather well. And now for the... Did I get enough? Shit. Let's see. First one, Castlevania. I don't know why I haven't owned this already, but I've only actually owned Castlevania 2 on the NES. Which is, you know, most people don't like that one. I really like it, but this is the best one to me. So finally, I have it. Thank God. Castle Quest. Now, the art looks fucking awesome. It really does. I assumed that you were like this knight character, but you're not. You're the fencing guy, which is fine. I like fencers. But the game's so fucking bad, it's not even worth it. So, how much does it cost me? $8? Great. Fucking waste my time. Hogan's Alley. That's a Zapper game. Everyone knows Hogan's Alley. Pro Wrestling, which is another childhood game. Why I fucking love this game. And it's still one of my absolute favorites to play. Fester's Quest. It's not terrible, but... What is Fester's Quest? Mylon's Secret Castle. I don't like this game. It's not fun. It pisses me off. It's tedious as fuck. Like, I would even say that Mylon's Secret Castle is like the game equivalent of going to the DMV. It's just fucking tedious. Terrible. Next one. Fuck. It's Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. And it's worse than Mylon's Secret Castle. At least this one's somewhat, like, somewhat playable. But you move so goddamn slow when you're Dr. Jekyll. Just... Dragon Power! I got it because the cover looks so ass that it had to be good. And actually, as it turns out, it is good. And in fact, it's a Dragon Ball game. They just called it Dragon Power in the States because we didn't have Dragon Ball. But like, you're Goku and you're searching for the Dragon Balls with Bulma. And they just kind of change the names around and alter some characters. That's it. So it's actually fucking awesome. Thank God for that. Sky Shark, which I got based on the cover alone. That guy's face amidst the chaos of war is one of my favorite fucking things ever. So I assumed this game would be really bad, but it's made by Taito. And they usually make good games. And this one is spectacular. Hard as shit, and I can't get past the first fucking stage. But maybe if I sit and like play it enough, I'll do it sometime. Super Pitfall. It's not a good game. It's not a bad game either, but it's kind of like Virtual Highline where it chugs along. It's like it always feels like the game's gonna fall apart. But I like the original Pitfall, so I grabbed this one for shits. And Wizards and Warriors, which is a lot of fun, but also tedious as fuck, and I don't even want to talk about it. I had such high expectations for that one, because I heard a lot of good things, and then I played it, and I was like, fuck my life. So that is Wizards and Warriors. Probably the best review of that ever. Now for this big fucking pile. Oh my god. There's still more there. Shit, what do they do? So I got some PS3 and PS4 games, and this is a DS one that is Theater Rhythm Final Fantasy Curtain Ball. It's a rhythm game. I like rhythm games, and it's got Final Fantasy characters, and I think it's cute, so I got it. No, not this one. No, no, wait. 3D Dot Game Heroes, which is basically, like, The Legend of Zelda, but it's by Atlas, and it's fucking awesome, and most people haven't played it because the name is shit. That's a shitty name for a game. What the hell are they thinking? Knights of... And this might be in the last episode. Fuck, I'm not sure. I don't know, it's not a bad game, it's just a hack and slash game. There's not a whole lot to explain there. Tales of Berseria. Awesome game, also might be in the last episode, but I'm drawing it in because I don't know. Picked up Lone Survivor, which is a limited run game. So it was digital for a while, and I've had it digital, but they released it on... Fuck. They released it on... These are very limited run games. They're rare. And I drop them. And they released it on Vita and PS4. So I got both of them because they're the kind of things that, like, maintain value. And then... Well, Resident Evil 7 came out, so I got fucking 4, 5, and 7. 7 is really good, I love it. There's some parts that suck ass, but for overall, it's a very good game, and I'm very happy with it, but then I got Resident Evil 4 again, and Resident Evil 5 again, because I need fucking 3 copies of each game I get for different consoles whenever I stop playing another one. Okay, and... Now I also got this amazing collector's edition for Odin Sphere on the PS4. And Odin Sphere is just an awesome side scroll and the artwork is spectacular. So when they released it on PS4, I figured I'd finally get it. And this is probably the best part, is it comes in like a steel slip case, which is fucking cool because the steel bookcases are ass and they're usually like this, but whenever you take the disc out, it feels like it's gonna break. And I hate that. So this is how you do a steel bookcase. In case anyone's wondering and they want to do it, this is how you do it. A slip case with a normal case inside. That's all we want. It looks good. That's it. We don't need to break the game every time we take the fucking thing out. Okay, so I have some fucking GameCube games, which I don't usually collect, but let's just get through them. This is The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, which surprisingly I've never played. I know that's like everyone's favorite, but I've never played it because I completely skipped the N64 era of Zelda games and intended to skip all Zelda games because I knew none of them would be as good as Zelda 2, which is the best Zelda game. And if you disagree, that's fine, but that's my favorite game. So, fuck you. But, yes, it's neat. I don't have much else to say. I don't have it on the N64, so it's good to have it on something so I can play it in some way. This one's Luigi's Mansion, which is one of the first GameCube games I ever had. And I accidentally, well, I didn't accidentally, but I sold my GameCube when I was a stupid teenager. Along with all my games that I love, and I regretted it, but now I have them back, so it's okay. MC Groove's Dance Craze. I like dancing games, so I got it. There's not really any on the GameCube. This one sucks a lot. Look at this. Featuring hit songs by Jessica Simpson, Jewel, Kevin Little. Anything good on here? When the best thing on your game is Casey and the Sunshine Band, you got some fucking problems. And this is a game made by Mad Cats, which is really weird because they usually only make accessories. So that's a thing that happened. This is a demo disc. That's all. I collect demo discs. I have a shit ton of them. Maybe I'll do a video on that because maybe I know I have over like 30 or 40 demo discs, like PlayStation ones. I love demos. I don't know why. Spyro Enter the Dragonfly. I've never actually played any Spyros except for the demos. I've played for, I believe, the first two. I think it's a Spyro and Ripto's Revenge, maybe? This is Star Fox Adventures, and it's garbage, but now I own it. This is a much better game, the Super Mario Sunshine. It's one of my absolute favorite games ever as well. I have a lot of those, but really, this is just a game that just makes me happy all the way through. Probably because it's really sunny and you're on this tropical island and it's not a bleak, gray, abysmal world. And Wario World, which is really awesome because I like Wario's fat, stupid, greedy ass. So there we go. That's that. And that's my GameCube games. I don't know what to go to next. Oh, you know what? I got one game left. Holy fucking shit, it's Chrono Trigger Complete in Box. This cost a lot of money. I got a decent enough deal, but holy shit, like, it has the maps and everything. I'm not even gonna open it because it's just gonna exist. But this is in great shape. And fuck. This is like one of those games like you have to get. It's like one of those Holy Grail games, if you will. So this is like right up there with my Bucky O'Hare and my Rule of Rose. And what else do we have? Oh god, how could I forget? I got the collector's edition of Catherine, which is, again, one of my favorite games. And probably my favorite PS3 game, next to like Demon's Souls and Dark Souls. But this game is just perfect. All the way through. I fucking love it. I can play it forever. And now I have a big ass box. So I can get... What does it even come with? Well, the box itself... box itself is like a pizza box for the bar that you go to in the game. Which I think is awesome, because... fuck, if that bar existed, I would be there all the time. And then it's like... there's the soundtrack and some shit in there. It's just perfect. It's a great game. If you haven't played it, I would say get it, because now apparently everyone is starting to play it again because speedrunners are starting to work on it, so that's cool. Brings a new life to that. And the new 3DS XL Pikachu. This was expensive. Not as expensive as Chrono Trigger, but close. And it's actually really awesome, and I got it solely because it has value. I'm probably never gonna use it, but it's worth money, so that's good. And okay, so the last thing, Nintendo Switch. So first of all, this box is the shit. They really know what they were doing when they packed this thing. I didn't have to go crazy and fucking kill myself and that's it. Like, that's your console. Obviously it's not in here. I had it set up already, but... awesome fucking box. Awesome packaging. And the console itself is very... what's a word that isn't awesome? Wonderful. Delightful. Fantastic. Spectacular. The irony is, the fucking box for Zelda is bigger than the box for the console. It's fucking ridiculous. But I accidentally, initially I canceled the order I had for the Switch, and I forgot to cancel this. So this came in, and I was like, well, shit. I didn't really want it, so I was thinking of selling it. But then I got the Switch as a gift, so it all worked out. Maybe I should show the console first. No, fuck it. I already got this box in my hand. We're gonna open the box. So, here we go. What does this shit come with? You got your game, which... I like it a lot. It's very minimal, which is good. There's no fucking words on the back. There's no manual. It's just artwork. And look at the fucking game. It's just this little SD card, which again, I also like. I mean, I kind of wish it had like a manual or something, but whatever. It takes up less shelf space, so that's good. You got the soundtrack. You got this coin thing for some reason. I don't know why. I think this is a map. Or just something awesome I can just put on the wall. Let's see if I could actually do this without destroying the whole... Can you please just fuck out? There we go. Let's, oh no. It's not a map. It's just an awesome thing from... Oh no. It is a map on the other side. This is fucking awesome. It has like a very, the texture is interesting. It's almost like canvas. It's fucking awesome though. So, alright. That's cool. I like a game that has a good map, even though it doesn't have a manual and you had to get the map with the collector's edition, which is horse shit. Hey, where'd the plastic go? Oh, fuck. I feel like the game should have just come with the map. I mean, the original Zelda came with the map. But whatever. Nintendo's making money, I don't give a shit. Oh, here we go. Oh, fuck, why did I take this out? These are the fucking... These are the problems I have. Fuck me, just... Try to make this as small as possible. Okay. That should do it. And then they can expand. What else did it come with? It came with this awesome... Try not to rip the packaging, but it's bound to happen at some point. This is... What is it? Oh, this is a case to carry the Switch. So, that's fucking cool. What is this shit? Oh yeah, hold all your games and whatnot. So, there you go. Ah, oh, it smells really good. Fuck. Put this shit away. So I basically lucked out with this because I had no intention of getting a Switch. Well, I did, but I canceled it and figured I'd get it down the road at another time. Now I have it, so I guess it worked out. So the console itself... Actually, wait, fuck. You know what? I just realized... We don't want to play that later, so I should probably take it out. Now, they also said that the games themselves taste bad. Like, they're coated with this thing, so that if a baby were to try to eat it, it would taste bad and they would not want to eat it. So they would spit it out. But, I don't know, it doesn't smell like anything, so I guess I'm going to try to taste the cartridge. It's really bad. It's really bad and it doesn't go away. Oh my god. I mean, it's smart for kids. Oh fuck. But it tastes really bad. Alright, so they weren't joking. It tastes really bad. Yay. Fucking hell. And, I guess I'll just show the console now. Let me rinse my mouth out. So finally the console itself, which is awesome, and I love that it's red and blue. This is it. This is the whole console. It hooks up to the TV through the dock, but fuck, this thing's neat. And it has the kickstand and all that other shit they show in advertisements, because these come off and then you can use them as single controllers on their own and just use this as a screen that's set up. And then obviously you can just dock it here, put in the dock, which the dock itself is fucking awesome because it has this door back here that flips down where the wires go. So this hides the wires. And since I have a lot of shit, I fucking hate wires being everywhere. So this is the little nerdy things that I appreciate. And this is the controller it comes with. So you just take this shit, slide it on, and there you go. Now you have a fucking controller. I think the controller's comfortable, like, on its own. That's because I don't have really fat hands, so I can imagine, like, this would be a real bitch, like, if you have bigger hands, which is very likely, because I have thin hands. So, it's comfortable for me, but I know a lot of people won't like it, so you're probably better off getting the Pro Controller. But I think that shit costs like $70, so I wouldn't even fucking recommend it. Like, at least wait for the price to go down or something, because that's ridiculous. And I think... shit, I got so much to clean up now. I think I'm gonna end it there, because I can't think of anything else. That should be everything since the last time, and obviously I'll do more when I get more, but... it's not likely, because I'm looking to, like, cut down on some of this shit. Because it takes up a lot of fucking room, and it costs a lot of money. The shit is not cheap. So, it may be a while till the next one, but... till then, I'll see you when I have more stuff and things. Or shit. When I have more shit. Alright, well, this just came in, so I figured I may as well tack it on to the back of this video, because why not? I'm just gonna open this and see what it is. Because I stopped checking, like, the emails and all that shit they spam you with to see what the theme is. I don't know what the theme is, but this shirt is fucking awesome. Link. I don't know how well you can see that, but... oh, fuck, this is so cool. And it's gray, thank god. I have too many fucking black shirts. Okay, what else is this? What the fuck is this? How do I open it? I'm gonna have trouble with this shirt. Says, world, open up. World of War, ooh, it's a beanie. It's a reverse movie, what's the other side? I don't know. And... the other side is this. Yeah, that's cool. Come on, it's warm and soft. I mean, hopefully it doesn't make me look too terrible. Toss that. What was the theme? Theme is wild. And I actually like the pin because it's a compass. And I like compasses. It's just something I really enjoy. Oh, this is... it's cute, but what is it from? Is this from... it's from Metal Gear Solid 5. Why can't I think of his fucking name? That's gonna bother me. And this... what the fuck? I wasn't expecting this, but... open up, goddamn. This is... canteen from one of my favorite Atari games, Pitfall. oh, this is neat. I don't know who decided to make this, but if I ever go on an adventure where I need to swing across vines over alligators, I would bring this with me. So that's kind of neat. These are nerdy things that I actually enjoy. What is this? This is just a car. Oh, we built a phone. This is just to show off their new logo. Cool. And then the rest is... This is the poster, and that's just gonna go in the garbage because I only put cool stuff on my wall. Not gonna lie, it's pretty awesome, but I still wouldn't hang it up. Yeah. Well, and that's that. So this wasn't so bad. It's silly. It's definitely silly, but I got a cool hat, and I got a cool shirt, and a canteen. I haven't had a canteen since I was a kid. Well, yes, I'm weird, and I'm gonna smell it. And that's all. So hopefully there's no more for a while. At least there should be. Bye-bye.